Please join me for the flag salute. Ready, salute, and pledge.
All right, Sean, what exactly is this scientific method?
If you're trying to solve a problem, let me be specific. You've got to use the method that's scientific. Observations. Observe, ask, look around, accept no imitations.
Two!
Make a prediction, an idea that you can test. That's your hypothesis. It's a kind of careful guess.
Three!
Experiment, experiment, and never let it rest. See if your hypothesis can pass the test.
Four!
Observe what happens and gather information. Look for any data that could give an explanation. Accurately measure with the tools you have around. Then get a pencil, make a list. Don't forget to write it down.
Five!
Draw conclusions about the things you saw. And see if a solution makes you say,
aha! Six!
You got results. What did you discover? Well, share your findings and get the word to others. You solved your problem in a way that's just terrific. You used the method that's I guess step six means we should be sharing the food we made with your mom and dad, Jet.
Watch Ready, Jet, Go! Weekdays on your PBS Kids station or anytime on the PBS Kids video app.
Students, are you interested in attending one of our nation's military academies, like West Point, Naval Academy, Air Force Academy? The United States Service Academy Information Night is going to be on Wednesday, September 20th, 2017, at Hanford West High School from 6:30 to 7:30.
On this day in history, in the year 70, Roman army under General Titus occupies and plunders Jerusalem. In 1921, in Atlantic City, New Jersey, the first Miss America pageant, a two-day event, is held. In 1986, Dan Marino throws his 100th career touchdown pass, making him the fastest to do so in quarterback history.
The next football, volleyball, and tennis games are follows. In football and volleyball, Monday, September 11th at Riverdale. Athletes will be released at 1:45 and the bus leaves at 2. Tennis, today, Thursday, September 7th at El Monte. Athletes will be released at 1:45 and bus leaves at 2.
7th and 8th grade students can now begin picking up CJSF applications now through Friday, September 1st. Applications are in the office.
Hi, we're here to talk about dress code for a minute. We've been tagging a lot of people who have been wearing wrong colors, so make sure that you pay close attention to what you can and cannot wear. It's in your parent-student handbook. Specifically, make sure you're paying attention that you're not wearing all blue or all red. The little Mark Twain light baby blue, that one's okay, but everything else, no good. As a matter of fact, let's go out here to this office. I want to show you something. Follow me, gentlemen. It's Mr. Mancia, it's right there. So over here, we've got some examples of shirts that you're not allowed to wear. We got a solid blue. Yeah, it's got a stripe, but it's basically a blue shirt. Solid blue, no good. Solid red, no good. Solid blue, solid blue, solid blue. All this blue, it's no good. She says, look in the box. Come closer, let's look in the box. So here we have some shirts available for you to wear. This one's a little wrinkled. I don't know what's going on here. For you to wear if
you don't have anybody who could bring you a shirt, we got some extra shirts for you. As a matter of fact, this summer, we ordered like 800 brand new t-shirts for you to wear. So if you get dress coded, you come into the office, you come right over here, Miss Cindy will give you this QR code for you to scan. You'll fill in a Google form, you'll switch out your shirts, bingo boingo, you're back in class. Make sure you're paying attention to the dress code. Any questions? I didn't think so. See you later.
Breakfast and lunch. Breakfast, cereal and yogurt. Lunch, chicken taquitos, extreme bean burritos, salad bar, fresh fruit.
Have a Wildcat day and remember Wildcat Ops. Respect for others, property, and self.